equation, we say that the total amount of power that your body produces has to be used by these factors: the horizontal resistance, the air resistance, and the climbing resistance. And if you know all those factors, you can calculate everything, even if you don't know the power of your human body. For example, the case of Usain Bolt. So we know that he ran 9:58 in Berlin. And we know that he did that at 20 degrees Celsius with a tailwind of 1 meter per second and with 1013 millibars of pressure. So we can say, well, what happened if it would be 25 centigrades, 5 degrees hotter? So the air density would be a little bit less, and he would gain 1/100 of a second. If there was a low pressure area in Berlin at that time, he would win another 2/100 of a second. If his headwind would be the allowable 2 meter per second, that's a big factor, he would win another 2/10 of a second. Going to altitude, to Mexico, is a very big factor. And if you could combine all these factors, so if you would run at altitude at 25 degrees with a low pressure and with 2 meters per second tailwind, you could theoretically run 9.18 instead of 9.58. Of course, it's only theory, but trust me, these calculations are exact. This is really true. What is not true, of course, is that you cannot predict that at the day that this race in Mexico is, that Usain Bolt will have exactly the same shape and the same power as he had on this day in Berlin when he was really in top shape. We made similar calculations for the world hour record of Bradley Wiggins. This is also an interesting one, because he improved the world record to 54 kilometers and 53 meters, 530 meters, so roughly 54 kilometers. That was the distance that he gained in 1 hour in London on the Olympic Velodrome. Last year it was. Now we know that for this record attempt, they heated the air in the velodrome to 27 degrees, just to reduce the air density and reduce the air resistance. So we have calculated what would have happened if they had not heated it, and the air would be 20 degrees. Well, he would have traveled half a kilometer less. What would happen if they could improve the aerodynamics further? That would be a big impact, of course. What would be the impact if he could push a little bit more power? We calculated that he pushed 468 watts, and if he hypothetically could have pushed 10 watts more, he could have traveled 400 meters more. Impact of depression. He was unlucky. He did this attempt during rather high air pressure, which was not good, of course. So if he would have waited 2 or 3 weeks for the depression to come, he might have improved his own record by a kilometer. And the big thing again is, if he had gone to Mexico, then he would have traveled or moved 3 kilometers further. So it's only a matter of time before some other cyclist, maybe not as good as Bradley Wiggins, but still a professional cyclist, if he goes to Mexico, he will improve Bradley Wiggins' record, because the impact of racing at altitude is much bigger than the difference between the elite cyclists. Okay, so this is all about the physics. And we try to make exact calculations and all the different equations to be able to calculate the physical resistances that you have to overcome when you are running. The running resistance, the air resistance, and the climbing resistance. Now we will go to the part which maybe interests you a little bit more, and that is the power of the human body itself. What can we say about that? How big is the power that you can produce when you are running? Well, obviously it depends on the time. If you are sprinting, you can produce more power than if you have to run a marathon. It depends obviously on your talent, so we will look closely to the world records and see what are the limits of human performance. It depends on training, on age and sex, on the altitude, because if you go to altitude, not only is the air resistance reduced, but also the availability of oxygen in your lungs and in your system is reduced, which has a negative impact on your on the power that you can produce, and factors like health and sickness, etc. So we will... Oh, hey, what happened here? We lose a slide. Yeah. But can we try to find...